You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I see.
Well, Jesus getting us ready for that great day. Jesus getting us ready. Jesus getting us ready. Who shall be able to stand? Oh, Jesus getting us ready. Great day. Jesus getting us ready for that great day. Jesus getting us ready for that great day. Who shall be able? Oh, Jesus getting us ready. Jesus getting us ready. Who shall be able? Oh, let it get you ready for that. Let it get you ready. Let it get you ready. For that great day, I'm praying to be ready. Yes, I'm praying to be ready. Who shall be able? They tell me sinners will be running. They tell me sinners will be running. Sinners will be running. Lily of the Valley Church of God in Christ, Bryan, Texas, live stream, Pastor Maurice Green Jr. We thank God for everybody in the viewing audience. We expect a great time in the Lord as we worship Him in the beauty of holiness. The praise team is coming and lead us in worship. Let's receive the praise team. Sister Veronica, Sister Angel, and Sister Monique, they're coming. Let's receive them in Jesus' name. Praying to be ready. Well, I'm praying to be ready.
Getting us ready for that great day. God is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. We come to give God praise on today. Right where you are, we want you to join in with us. Give God praise. Stand up on your feet. Hallelujah. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Hallelujah. God is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is great and greatly to be praised. Glory, glory to his name. God is great and greatly to be praised. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. God is great,
God is great
to be praised.
Glory, glory
to
his name.
I tell you, God
is great
and greatly to be praised.
You
you come to do. Glory to God. worthy. We come to give God praise. Hallelujah. We come to lift him up. We come to give him praise. Hallelujah. We come to lift him high. Hallelujah. For there's nobody like our God. Hallelujah. In all the earth. Hallelujah. Can't find nobody. Searched all over. Can't find nobody. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your name, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your name, God.
Oh,
We worship him. We bless him. We adore him. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless your holy name. Bless your holy name. Bless your holy name. God bless everybody there. Viewing, we give God the praise, the glory, and the honor. We give God praise for the praise team, amen, and their labor. The joy of the Lord is our strength. We gird up the loins of our minds, and we are sober, and we're watching unto prayer. This is a celebrated hour. Hallelujah, the King of Kings reign supreme. This is a glorious hour. Hallelujah. While the body of Christ is in preparing, waiting for the day of the Lord. Hallelujah. We are steadfast. We are unmovable. We are waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God in patience for the joy of the Lord. That's our strength. And with joy. Help me say, and with joy. And with joy. We draw water out of the wells of salvation. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Hallelujah. I will praise the Lord. I will keep his praises continually in my mouth. Joy bells just keep on ringing. Hallelujah in my soul. Peace, peace, peace from God Almighty. Come on, let's bless the Lord. Let's take opportunity to to shout and to rejoice, for great is the Lord in our midst. Handio bashandio, and he's greatly, greatly to be praised. Hallelujah, shanandio, shando. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We praise him. Hallelujah. For his manifold blessings. The windows of heaven are open. And God is showering us with his benefits. No wonder David said, I will look to the hills from whence cometh my help. In this pandemic where some are struggling, God has given you an increase. Hallelujah. The windows of heaven are open unto you. Hallelujah. And you can declare that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not walk. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside that still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. The pandemic is still spiking. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup is running over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days. Somebody shout, for the Lord is good. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody rejoice in the Lord. Glory, joy, this joy I have, the world didn't give it to me. Hallelujah, it came with a price. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, but he washes whiter than snow. I am numbered among the redeemed of the Lord, and I don't mind saying so, for the Lord has delivered me from the hand of that enemy. Gave me power over death, over hell, and the grave. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. I just want to pause and give him all the glory. I just want to pause and bless his name, for the Lord, he's worthy. He's worthy. To the Aluva Kanayo, he's giving you all the machino. He's worthy. Ta-ta-ta-ta. Oh, glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. It just keep on ringing. Yes, Lord. Joy bells. It just keep on ringing. Joy. Joy bells, joy like a river, keep flowing, hallelujah, out of my belly. Yes, Lord, I thank the Lord, I praise the Lord, I give him glory, I give him the honor. Worthy, that's what I tell him. I say, Lord, you're worthy of all my energy, all that I can muster, all that I can bring forth. You're worthy of it all. And give me some more strength so that I can bring some more praise. Hallelujah. Let it turn over and over. Let the wheel of prayer and praise continue in me. Have your way, pour out of your spirit so you can get the glory you deserve. All the glory, all the honor, you're worthy, Lord. Come on, you there viewing, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise God in the firmament of his power. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Well, you there viewing, you don't have to be in the lily of the valley to praise God. Right there in the confines of your home, you can praise him right there. Hallelujah. If you don't mind, I'll give the musicians a few seconds to give you some praising music, some shouting music. Go ahead and praise him. Bless the Lord. I just thank God for the opportunity to come before his presence with singing, to know that the Lord, he is God. It is he. Tati Kuka Tina Tona Dio Ushke. Woo! Shaka. Hey! Yala Buka Landa Shara. Hey! Ta-ta-ta-ta. Hey! Shabule! Kurande o tukule kandi leki mo ba shadama. Yes, Lord! Thank you! Jesus! Thank God for the Holy Ghost that makes intercession for us, seeing that the Lord will put no more on us than we are able to bear. Sometimes in school, when you had a rigorous moment of curriculum, they give you a break, they give you a recess. God knows how much to put on us at one time, seeing we are still in this frame. But then after a while, God will give us a breakthrough so that we can rejoice in the midst of our trials, in the midst of our troubles, in the midst of our struggle. We can stand flat-footed in the face of the enemy and say like Job, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. All the days of my appointed time, I'm waiting for my change to come. But while I'm waiting, I'm gonna give his name the praise. While I'm waiting, I'm gonna bless his name. I'm gonna take time out while I'm going through. Seemingly my back's against the wall, but I'm gonna bless the Lord anyhow. I'm gonna praise him. I'm gonna give him the glory, for he's worthy, for he's worthy. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Lord. Hallelujah. Thank God for the Holy Ghost power. Going to the scripture in the book of Genesis. The third chapter of the book of Genesis. Hallelujah. Thank God for Jesus. Genesis 3 and 15.
And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel.
I want to give some clarity, if you will. I'm going to the book of St. John, the first chapter, and I will refer back to some scriptures as I state my case. St. John 1 and 41.
He first findeth his own brother, Simon, and said unto him, we have found the Messiah, which is, being interpreted, the Christ.
Read it one more time, Sister Green, because that's where I'm going to take and make my argument. Come on.
He first findeth his own brother Simon.
He findeth his brother Simon.
And said unto him.
He was excited when he found his brother Simon Peter. He said to his brother when he found him.
We have found the Messiah.
We have found the Messiah. Go ahead.
Which is being interpreted the Christ.
Which is being interpreted the Christ. We found the Christ. If I would use four texts today. And I'll go to my scriptures. But I want to announce my text. I would ask us a question. Have we found him yet? I didn't ask you, were we shouting and dancing? I didn't ask you whether we were singing jubilistic songs. I didn't ask you, were we testifying? I'm asking, have we found sufficient evidence that would declare that he is the Christ? Because when he's found his brother, Peter, he said, we have found him. Is this not the Christ? In other words, if he declared that we found him, what evidence did he associate finding him with? In other words, we have found him. And we found him based on scripture. The scripture declared, and based on scripture, we identify that this got to be him. So I ask the question again. Have we found him? What scripture do we have to validate the fact that Jesus not only died, but before he died, the scriptures declared that he was coming. We got to have some foundation so that we can make our calling and our election sure. Sure meaning sound. Your testimony, your argument is sound, and your sound based not on what you say, but based on what God has foresaid. Hallelujah. So, read it again, Sister Green.
He first findeth his own brother Simon and saith unto him, we have found the Messiah, which is being interpreted the Christ.
Now, Sister Green, go back to 3 and 15 of Genesis.
And I will put enmity between thee and the woman.
After Adam's sins and his wife, God speaking to the serpent, seeing man's relationship with God is spoiled because of sin and transgression. God is not willing that any should perish. He declares salvation through that second Adam. He declares deliverance from that sinful nature. He implements a plan of redemption, and he puts Jesus in play. Said the woman is going to bring forth a seed, and her seed is going to be enmity between you and it. So then Matthew said, she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. Sister Green, go to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah, the 9th chapter. And the 6th verse. We found him yet? Come on, Sister Green.
For unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Sister Green, hold that scripture and go to the book of 1 Samuel 2 and 10. Have we found him yet? First Samuel 2 and 10.
The adversaries of the Lord shall be broken to pieces. Out of heaven shall he thunder upon them. The Lord shall judge the ends of the earth, and he shall give strength unto his king and exalt the horn of his anointed.
His anointed. God further indicates the coming of the Messiah. The government she just read in Isaiah is going to be upon his shoulder. He'll have the authority. He will reign in dignity. He is the Son of the living God. He is the promised seed. He is the one that he was talking to Peter, his brother, that we have found him. The scriptures declared him, and we have found him. Yes, he is walking in strength. He's walking in power. He is God's anointed. He asked the question, is not this the Christ? Is not this the one that God promised? The anointed one, the one that the scripture declared, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings to the meek. He sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. This is my platform. This is my government. This is the way I will operate. So my declaration is, they were waiting for a promised Messiah. They were not just idly existing. Situations and circumstances caused them to anticipate change. They didn't like where they were, and I likened it to those people that were enslaved, that were taken from their native land and boarded on ships, in the hull of ships, chained together in their own secretions. They had to exist, and then brought to a country that was foreign to them, and to be brutalized, to be lynched, to be humiliated. They looked for change. When Declaration of Independence or Juneteenth came, they rejoiced. Though they didn't understand that kind of freedom at that time, they did not hesitate to rejoice. I imagine they had jubilee. They had shouting and praising. They had been praying a long time. They had wondered a long time, will I ever get out of these chains? Will I ever get out of Jim Crow? But one day, the Lord delivered them. Well, these people had heard the prophets prophesy of the coming of the Lord, attached to the promise of Genesis 3 and 15, that God was going to avenge them of the adversary. I'm going to give you power over all the power of the enemy. Power to tread on serpents and scorpions. I'm going to deliver you from your bondage. I'm going to call you trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. I'm going to bring you out of your captivity. I'm going to loose loose you from your chains, from your shackles. I got a new day. I'm going to open up the windows of heaven. I'm going to destroy what the canker worm, the caterpillar, the palmer worm. I'm going to restore.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. Shasha took a deep. So they were waiting for the coming. He says, we have found him. Read that ninth chapter of Isaiah and the sixth verse again. Let's see if we can't celebrate what they were celebrating. See if we can't rejoice in more than saying I'm saved. Let's see why I'm saved, and let's see what brought it about. Yeah, got a lot of people that are rejoicing in the Juneteenth celebration. They never been in captivity like that before. They never been humiliated, and some of them never been like I was, had to go to the back door. Couldn't sit in the restaurant. Had to go all the way to the back to order your food. Or go to a colored-only water fountain. Or colored-only bathroom. Hallelujah. Before we had running water in the house. Hallelujah. Had to bring the dip of the water bucket. Hallelujah. Before we had running water in the bathtub. Or inside toiletries. Hallelujah. They don't know anything about that. But hallelujah, we that have been delivered from that, we know what it feels like not having going to the outhouse. Hallelujah, we know what it feels like not to have Charmin. Hallelujah, so we can rejoice in a way that others can't because they've never been without. Well, I understand then these individuals had been waiting for the promised Messiah. And then he says to Peter, I believe we found him. Is not this that one that is anointed? God has set him aside to come and bring deliverance to the captive. Come on, Sister Green.
For unto us a child is born.
I mean, we got to have another reason. More than what we do, because we don't shout and we don't rejoice. We don't make enough noise about this Savior. Hallelujah. About this deliverer. Hallelujah. Somebody said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out. But I want to go beyond what he's done for me. I want to go back to where he promised that he would send him and that he would be bruised for my iniquities, wounded for my transgressions, and the chastisement of my peace. I want to say, that's him. I've experienced him. I'm one of them. I am the redeemed of the Lord. The blood of the new covenant has prevailed to change my vile nature. I'm saved by his power.
Thank you, God. Thank you.
Come on, Sister Green.
For unto us a child is born.
Unto us. A child is born.
Unto us a son is given.
He's talking about that seed. I want to be able to associate what Isaiah the prophet is saying. I want to be able to tap here and go back to Genesis and pick Genesis up. That he's got a plan. And the enmity that God has put in place is going to be in the child that's born and the son that is given. Let's see what he's going to do. Come on, Sister Green.
And the government shall be upon his shoulder.
The government, the power to execute, the authority to bring peace and harmony, to bring order. He's got power. He's the governor.
Thank
He oversees the operation.
Thank you, God.
Everything is subject to him.
Oh, bless God.
He's got all power. He's sovereign. He reigns. Come on, Sister Grace.
And his name shall be called Wonderful.
You got to understand that when you are going through this battle is not yours. God never designated it to you. He put that government up on his shoulder. His power is to bring enmity between the seeds, but he reigns supreme. That's why he said, I give you power over all the power of the enemy. Power to tread on serpents. He did say serpents. I give you authority. You are the enmity between the seed of the woman and the seed of the serpent. I give you authority. Come on, Sister Green.
Counselor.
Counselor.
The mighty God.
The one that Paul asked the question, who shall separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus? What power, what authority, not even death, not even life, not height, not depths, no angels, not principalities, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. I count these things to be enemy forces, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Notwithstanding, rejoice not, because the spirits are subject unto you. He did say subject. He said, but rather rejoice. Because your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. God has given the Lamb power to make sons of God, to make heirs and joint heirs. For whom the Son set free is free indeed. He's got power. He's got the governorship. He's in authority. He reigns. All of the authority and order come from him.
Bless God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, Sister Green.
The everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Now he has given us intelligence when we did not have it. He's given us intelligence of how to worship, because that was the Father's will, that they might be one with us. That's what he did when he brought reconciliation. He brought two parties estranged back together. So he brought harmony and peace and tranquility, because God was not willing that I should perish. I was perishing in that first Adam, and enmity was in that first Adam. But Christ came to destroy that enmity. He came to silence what was hindering my relationship with the Father. Then that second Adam came and said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. I've come to give you rest. Well, that's what they've been waiting for. That's what they were waiting to hear declared. The King of Kings. Well, I hear David says, lift up your head, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of Glory. Where there is a king, there must be a kingdom. And Jesus prayed, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Well, the will of the Lord is that all be saved, that all come to repentance. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
He has authority. He has power. He is the manifestation of the invisible God. God has taken on flesh. For the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Shikukulumakure miambula kukumbwale. Here he comes declaring righteousness, peace, and joy. He is the gospel personified. Finish me, Sister Green.
Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice. From henceforth, even forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
My God, listen to me. They were waiting for the manifestation of a promise. God had given them hope. I don't know if we don't tie ourselves to that. I know you said that's the Old Testament, but the Old Testament declared a coming event. Well, those prophets prophesied what would come to pass. I don't want to be ignorant of the Old Testament prophetic utterance, because I believe that was what they hoped for. That's what God gave them in the prophecy. He gave them hope. So they looked for a coming Messiah. They looked for another king. They'd had kings like Jehoshaphat. They'd had kings like Saul. They'd had David's and Rehoboam's, Ahab's, but they never had a king of kings. Did you come and else you know? They never had a Lord of lords. They were just a symbol or a show of the one that was to come. Hallelujah. So they waited for that Moses figure. Said he gonna raise up a servant, a serpent, a prophet like me. Yeah. He said, Moses prophesied of me. Come on, Sister Green, go with me to the book of St. John, the 5th chapter. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. St. John 5:39.
Search the scriptures.
Search the scripture.
For in them ye think ye have eternal life.
The scriptures is going to make you think. In other words, they're going to condition you to think past where you are. They're going to tie you into what pertains to eternal life. So search the scriptures. He said, because you didn't know me. Yeah. Read that 38th verse, Sister Green.
And ye have not his word abiding in you, for whom he has sent, him ye believe not.
He said, you didn't believe me. See, I believe that if we don't have enough foundation, you're going to be easily thrown off. You got to be anchored. I'm not talking about anchored in anything. I'm talking about anchored in God's word. For God is not a man that he should lie. I'm going to ask the question again. Have we found him? Because when you find him, you don't have to have the music to dance. When you find him, everything don't have to be going well. For you to trust him. No wonder Job says, my righteousness will I hold fast and I will not let it go. I know that my Redeemer liveth.
Thank you, God.
I want you to understand, this is Job talking. I know that my Redeemer liveth. And that he shall stand in the last day. In other words, not only is he living, but he's going to be living forever. So all the days of my appointed time, I got enough faith and confidence to know I can wait until my change comes. It's got to be past your head knowledge. It's got to be rooted and grounded.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's what he means when he said steadfast, unmovable. That's why he said, now unto him that is able to keep you from falling.
Yes.
What's in you is sufficient to keep you against that day. Because the devil is very subtle. He came to Jesus, and Jesus didn't make it no different. Get thee hence behind me, for it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. That's why I said, now search the scriptures.
Yes, search the scriptures.
Take time out.
Glory to God.
Investigate. See if you can't find Jesus somewhere in the scriptures. For the scriptures declare him.
Read that 39th verse, Sister Green.
Search the scriptures, for in them ye think ye have eternal life.
Watch what he says.
And they are they which testify of me.
He said, those scriptures that you're searching, if you search them, you're going to find out that they're going to testify. Oh, my God. Out of your belly, if you believe on me, as the scriptures have said, out of your belly shall flow. Search the scriptures.
Search, hallelujah.
For in them you think you have eternal life. And they are they. The scriptures.
Yes.
They are they. Scriptures is the subject. Search the scriptures.
Yes.
They being the pronoun, referring back to the noun.
Scriptures.
They are they which testify of me. The scriptures are going to tell you about me.
Thank you, God.
For man shall not live by bread alone.
Thank you, God.
Sanctify them through thy truth.
Word.
Thy word is truth. It's something stabilizing in the word of God.
Thank you, God.
Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. For I reckon that the suffering of this present time is not worthy to be compared to the glory that shall be revealed in us. Somewhere in the scriptures, Jesus spoke it, said, if you suffer with me, that's what he said in the scriptures, if you suffer with me, you can reign with me, and all that will live godly shall persecution. Well, Paul took it up. He said, I fought a good fight. He said, I finished my course. He said, I kept the faith. He said, henceforth, there's laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, that righteous judge, hath prepared. Some glad morning, when this life is over, I shall fly away. Hallelujah. To a land on God's celestial shore, I'll fly away. Well, the scriptures declared, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. I hear him saying, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Hallelujah. All we got to do is wait on the Lord. For the writer declared, they that wait upon the Lord shall be like Mount Zion. They shall not be moved. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Now, unto him that's able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. Hallelujah. I got a hope that lies within, something on the inside, working on the outside, the joy of the Lord, that's my strength. I heard the word, and I believe the word. I hold to the word. If you abide in me, and my word abide in you, I just want to dwell in the secret place of the Most High so that I can abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Wait, I say, wait on the Lord. Wait through your trial. Wait through your circumstances. Song said, victory, victory shall be mine if I hold my peace. I got a reason to hold my peace, because my peace, my deliverance is all in him, and he is the source of my desire. He is the peace in my soul. He is my joy, my contentment. No wonder I can press, cause it's no more I, but it's Christ that dwells within. When I meet my challenger, I'm more than a conqueror. Satan is already defeated, cause I got enmity in me against that enemy. And greater is he, and greater is he that's within me. And I can do all things through Christ. My enemy is already defeated. He's under my foot. I've got his head, and I'm bruising it through the power of the reign. Jesus, that King of Kings, he reigns, he reigns, he reigns. Have we found him yet? The scriptures declare
Have we found him? I hear the song say, Jesus said it. Jesus said it. Scripture said it. Scripture said it. Believe on me. Believe on me. Believe on me. As the scripture said, out of your belly. He said, if you believe on me. He said, if you believe on me. He said, out of your belly. Out of your belly. It's going to start flowing rivers of living water. If the rivers flow, you won't stagnate. You won't die. Because the rivers give life. And he is life of the believer. He is the joy that keeps you encouraged. He is the power that gives you the victory. He is the shout in your joy. He keeps you with a mind stayed on him. All we got to do is wait. Wait on him. Wait. Wait on him. Jesus said it. 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 Scripture said it. Scripture said it. Scripture said it. Scripture said it. Believe on me. Believe on me. Believe on me. Believe on me. Out of your belly. Out of your belly. Out of your belly. Out of your belly. Flow, 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 river, 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 that living water, that living water, I got a river, I got the river. That river, I got that river, that living water, that living water, that living water, that living water, that flow, 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 river, river. Thank God for the King. He reigns. I don't have no problem calling him King of Kings. For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. I want to thank God for his word coming alive. Jesus said in the word, to as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. Now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Behold, what manner of love the Father had bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Yes, Lord. Thank you. Thank God. Shasha. Oh, my God. Thank God. He called me son. Woo! Shabo! Ow! He called me son. Hey, yeah, yeah. He called me son. What about you? Yes, Lord. Now, God, I want to thank you for your word, for the power of that word. Thank you for life that's in that word. For the word is life, and the life is the light of men. Thank you for the shining light that lightens up the world. Thank you for eternal life. You're worthy. Yeah. You're worthy. And I know my Musha. Thank you. Come on, clap your hands. God, I want to thank God for every father that's out there that are viewing. I want to say happy Father's Day to you and to your families. It's not good for man to be alone, so God gave man a helpmeet, and the man and the woman were given instructions to multiply and to replenish. Have a great day today. Enjoy family. Enjoy your day. Let them make a fuss over you. Enjoy the Lord. I want to thank God. I want to encourage us. Find him. Find him. Find him. He said, when you find me, walk therein, seek for the old path, then shall you find me when you search for me with your whole heart. Diligence causes me to press. Don't give up. I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna be like Jacob. I ain't gonna let you go till you bless my soul. I'm gonna be so blessed when I find him. He said, you're gonna know more about me as you follow on to know me. In other words, I wanna spend time with him so I can get to know him. Paul said, not as though I'd already attained, neither were already perfect, but I follow after that I might apprehend that for which I was also apprehended of in Christ. Sha-ta-ta-sha-ta-ta. Come on, let's dismiss. Na 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 muyelo. Tati she. Dying shine, yeah. One of my nine and only under ocean and I knew. Thank you for the Holy Ghost that's keeping
the believer safe, secure, anchored, unmovable. The word of God, sustaining joy, peace, and righteousness in the Holy Ghost. Now God bless everybody that's viewing. Let the anointing of the Holy Spirit inspire us to press our claim. Yes, to stake our claim on eternal life and not to move the ancient landmark, but to abide in the Lord. In Jesus' name, God bless you. God keep you. That's my prayer.